Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see magical candy store question that came in November long challenge. Basically this question is of observation. If you have not tried this question till now, just go and try. I will recommend you just go and give it a try. If you are not able to understand the question or if you are not able to solve or develop approach to solve this question, just see this video, follow this video step by step. I will also explain you the question, then I will also help you to develop the logic how to solve this question, then I will also show you the later implementation of this question. Okay, now let's read the question. Chef and Shefu are at a magical candy store playing a game with the following rules. There are two candy stores. Each of them stores an infinite number of candies. At any time, only one of the counter is open and other is closed. You can think of two candy store. This is candy store 1. This is C2. Okay. These are two stores. And at any time, only one will be open, one will be closed. Okay. No, the both cannot be remain open. Only one will be opened at one time. Exactly one player is at each of the counter. Initially, chef is at the open counter and Shefu is at the closed counter. Okay, so initially you can say chef, Shefu. Okay, suppose this C1 counter is open, so chef will be always in the beginning at the open counter and Shefu will be always at the closed counter. This is what this statement is meaning. Okay, there is a sequence of n distinct integer a1 to an. The game consists of r turns. In the ith turn, the open counter offer only C equals to AI minus 1 mod n plus 1 candies to the player present at this counter. This player should choose a positive number of candies M to accept, where M is between 1 to C. Now what this paragraph means? Okay, this, what this point means? That we will be given N distinct integers. That is, suppose it, if it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and N is equal to 5. Okay, then and distinct integers, they cannot be same. Just please focus on this, that and distinct integers, they will be not same. So there will be no value repeated. They will be all be different values. Okay, the game consists of r turns, and in the ith turn, the counter which is open will offer us this. The formula will be applied to get the number of candies. Now what is this formula? When we put C is equal to A of I minus 1 mod n plus 1. This is what they mean. Now, if I am starting from index 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is index, suppose, and this is the value. Then 1 minus 1 mod 5 plus 1 will be always 1 only. You will get 1 only. Okay, similarly we will get 2 for 2, 3 for 3, 4 for 4. This is how we will utilize this formula. And out of this, from 1 to C, we can select any number. If there is, if value of C is equal to 6, suppose, then from 1 to 6, we can choose any value and we can give it to the player which is present at the open store. Okay. If this player accepts an odd number of candies, the player have to swap this position. Suppose if chef is there and Shefu is there and the option is to get the candies between 1 to 6. Okay, chef is present at the open store and he can select. Now if we select 3, then now chef will be at Shefu will be at chef's position and chef will be at Shefu's position. If he selects an odd number, 3 is an odd number, so this is what this line means. Okay, now after each n turns, the counter which was currently open is closed and the counter which was currently closed is open. Now if there is, if after n turns, suppose n is equal to 5 and this counter 1 is here and counter 2 is here. So after 5, this is initially, this is open, this is closed. After 5 turns, this will be closed and this will be open. This is what this line means. The primary goal of each player is to maximize his own number of candies after r turns As a second priority, each player wants to minimize the number of candies his opponent has after our turn. So this line means that the goal of the any player who is playing, whether it's chef and shefu, they want to maximize their number of candies, and they also want to minimize the number of candies of shefu. Okay, now this, how we will achieve this, this I will explain you in while building the approach. Okay, you should process Q queries, and each Q, in each query you are given R, and you should find the number of candies chef has after R turns. Assuming that both players play game optimally, we have to calculate the number of candies that we can get, the chef can get, if maximum, suppose if there is a 7 rounds, okay, then after 7 rounds, how many maximum candies this chef can get? This is what we have to calculate in this question, okay, after R terms. And this, since the number could be very large, so we will compute it modulo 10 power 9 plus 7. This is what this question is asking. This was the explanation of the whole question. Now we will look the logic, and we will try to build the logic and approach that will be used to solve this question, that how we can solve this question. Okay, let's see that. So here I have written all the important pointers, that LA elements are array elements are distinct, that is, they are different. There can be only unique elements. The element once used cannot be used next time. Okay, if any player chooses odd number of candies, his position will be swapped with the other player. After n terms, shop which was open will be closed, and other shop was which was closed will be open. Player can choose candies between 1 to C. Okay, and this is the formula to choosing candies for every player. Okay, now let's look at this example. N is equal to 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And there are 4 queries. What will be the number of candies maximum chef can have after first round? As initially, chef is only present at the open counter, so he can has 2 candies. Okay, so at 1 is equal to 2. 2 candies. What will be after 4 round? After 4 round, what will be the answer? But before that, what will be the after 2nd round? But after 2nd round, he can get 3 candies. But if he select these 3 candies, okay, because see, what is this 2nd round? A of 2, if I mark this index as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, at 2nd round, A of 2 minus 1 mod 5 plus 1 is nothing but 2 only. Okay, so you can see that if C is equal to CI is equal to C at 2nd round, that C2 is equal to A2 only. Okay, now at 2nd round he can get at max 3 candies. Okay, but if he will select odd number of candies, he has to switch his position, and they both play optimally, so he will select only even number of candies. Okay, so that he has to not switch his position, otherwise the now position of chef will be replaced with the shefu. So at 2 also he will select 2 only. At 3 he can get at max 4, and 4 is even, so he will select this 4. At 4 he can select at most 5, but will he select 5 or 4? And we have to get the answer after 4 round only. So he can select the 4, but he is assuming that after 4 round the game will be finished. So we have to print the best answer after 4 round. Best answer will be when we consider 5, because we have to not see further. If the answer, if the question is 6, then only we will select at 4 even number of count. Otherwise we will go with the number which is present at that point. Okay, so 4 equals to 5 candies. So total number of candies which he can get is 5, 4, 9, 2, 11, 2, 13. Okay, so at 4 you can say that 13 candies at max he can get. Okay, this can be the answer. Now at 5, but when will we select, when we check for 5, then he cannot select that 5 at 4. Why? Because if he will select 5 at 4, then he will change the position at 5, and he will change the position with shefu, and at 5 shefu will come, and at 5 he will get no, at 5th round he will get no count, or he will be storing 0 count. So to avoid that, at 4 let's write it, at 1 he will choose 2, at 2 is equal to 2, at 3 is equal to 4, and 4 is equal to 4 only. He will select 4 candies only. And at 5, he will select 6 candies only. Why 6? Because he wants the best at that moment, at 5. So the total number of candies, 4 to 6 to 8, 4, 12, 6, 18. 18 at 5 is equal to 18. Now, at 6, what he will select? At 1, again, he will select 2. At 2, again, he will select 2. At 3, again, he will select 4. At 4, again, he will select 4. At 5, will he select at 5, 6 or 5? Just think, just look at this pointers, these pointers here, and just think that will he select 5 candies or 6 candies? Just think here. He will select 5 candies. Why he will select 5 candies? Because as written here that after n turns, and n is equal to 5. So after 5th turn, the shop which was open is now closed, and shop which was closed is now open. So he will swap the position, and Shefu is present currently at the closed one, which will be opened after 5 turns. So he will play smartly, and he will choose the odd one, odd integers. Okay, so that why it's so that he can swap his position with Shefu, and Shefu comes here. Now after n turns, this shop will be closed and this will be open. So he will select only 5. And at sixth turn, now apply that formula. C is equal to A of 6 minus 1 mod 5 plus 1. What is the formula? It is giving us A of 1. And what was A of 1? A of 1 is 2. Okay. So at 6, he will select 2. Because he had to get the optimum, and however he will select the even number only. So the total candies after 6th round that he can get is 4 to 6 to 8, 4, 12, 17, 19. 19 candies he can get. Okay. So this was the condition when there is no 1 in this array. Okay. Now we will select those condition if where there is 1. But before that, I want you to observe that what we have done here, that case 1 you can make, that when there is no 1, then what we are doing, we are simply taking even number at every round. Okay, if it is odd, then we will subtract at ith element, if the number present, element present is odd, number of candies present is odd, we will subtract it with my minus 1. But we will perform only till the r minus 1. We have to tell the query after r round. So we will perform till this point till only r minus 1. At rth point, we will include the whole element, whether it's odd or even, we will include the rth element. That is A of r minus 1 mod n plus 1. We will include this whole element, whether it is odd or even, this whole element will get added. Okay. And always the chance will be always with chef only. Why? He will play optimally and he will always choose the even number. So this you can observe from this when there is no 1 present. Now case 2, when 1 is present. And 1 will be only present once because there are distinct element is present. So 1, where can be 1 present? It can be present in beginning, in middle. In middle, I mean that at any point between beginning and end, and in end. Let's start with end point. Okay. Suppose the 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. This is the array. Okay. Now at 2, chef will add this 2. Chef will take 2 at when I'm assuming that r is equal to 5. I have to tell that what is the count after 5th round. Then he will take this 2. He will similarly take this 4. He will similarly take this 4 from here. Why not 5? Because then he have to say change this. Now 1. At 1 he do not have any option, because the minimum number of candies that chef can or any player can take is greater than equal to 1 and less than equal to C. So he cannot choose less than 1 element. He cannot choose less than 1 element. He has to, if there is 1 present, then he has to choose 1 element. Okay. Due to this condition. So he will choose this 1 element. It will be beneficial for him only. Why? Choosing the odd index at nth integer will place him again at the open shop, because he will swap his position with the Shefu, and his position will be swapped with Shefu, and he will be again present at the open shop, which is open. So he will be choosing this one only at nth index. Okay, so the total count after 5 will be 2 + 2 = 4, 8, 12, 13 will be answer in this case. Okay, now if I say that what you have observed here in this, when n is equal to 1, when 1 is present in n, we will perform the similarly. So we will perform the similar operation, that choose even till n minus 1, and at nth choose 1. Here choose means add 1 to the total candies. Okay, and after adding 1, this till where we will perform this operation? This will be performed till r minus 1. At rth, what we will add? We will add simply a of r minus 1 mod n plus 1. This we will add. This candy, this the number of candies present here will be added here automatically. Okay, so this was the explanation when 1 is present at, in the end. Now when 1 is present in middle, what will happen then? When 1 is present in middle, in between beginning and end, let's take 2, 3, 1, 4, 5. Okay, now this is the condition, then what will happen? Then Chef will start playing. He will choose even number. Now here he will choose even number or odd number? Just pause the video and think on it. I want you to just pause the video and think on it. We will select odd number. We will not select even number. We will select odd number. Now why we will select odd number? Because we are getting 1 here. And now if we will select, suppose if we are selecting even number. For once, let's suppose we are selecting even number. Now 4. Now Chef has came, got here. Now 1, he had not, he do not have any choice. He will select 1 only. And if, when he will select 1, then he has to change his position with Shefu. Now Shefu will get the chance. And now Shefu will select 4. And this, then he again he will select 5. Now he will be present at the, Shefu will be present at the, you can say, open shop after n turns. Then again he will select 2. Then again, now when he will select the odd number, then what happens? That I want to explain to you. Okay. Just see here that when Chef will select the odd number, that is 3, then now he has swapped his position. Now he has swapped this position with the Shefu. Okay, he is now on closed 1. Now Shefu came and Shefu selected 1. He has no option. He will select 1. At this point, Chef will select 0 and Shefu, it 1 will go to Chef. Okay, sorry, Shefu. Okay, now he, after selecting 1, he again, Chef again comes back to this open store. Okay, and again he can select this even number and perform the same operation, select odd at n minus 1th integer to avoid changing position of the closed store. Okay, so again he will perform these operation only. So this is why I am saying that when 1 will be in between, we will select the odd integer when this before. Then we will select only odd integer before 1. Okay, this is what we will do in between beginning and end, when 1 is present in between beginning and end, and rest of all will be same. Okay, at we will perform this operation till, you can say, rth element, and at rth element we will use this formula to add the value at rth element. Okay, now the point comes when n is at beginning. Sorry, 1 is at beginning. Suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then Chef do not have any option. Then Chef will present after 1. What will be the answer? 1 only. Because Chef do not have answer, he will select. Now Shefu has got the player. The Shefu has got the this point. Okay, the Shefu has came to open store. Now at 2 also it will be 1, because it will go at 1 Shefu. Let's denote it with this Chef and Shefu. Then you will understand better. At 1, Shefu was 0. Now at 2, Shefu will be 2. Because he is also playing optimally. at 3 he will also be 1, at 3 he will be 4 because he will be using even index. He will also follow the same strategy, optimal strategy. 4 it will be 1, 4 it will be 4 plus 4 8, he will select 4 this one. At 5 it will be 1, at 5 this will be, now he will be choosing odd number or even number. Just think on it, he will choose odd number or even number. I hope you would have thought that he will select even number. Why he will select even number? 8 plus 4 equals to 12. Why? So that he do not swap his position. Now chef is present at this position. Now you can say that Shefu is present at this position, at the position of losing. You can say that where he will he has to select this integer, he has to select this integer 1, this number of candies 1, so he will become 2. And now, but there is a catch. This is the edge case. At after 6 then he will be 12, and after 7 again he will be 14. But there is a catch. This is edge case. This will be only valid answer when we have asked for 7th round or 8th round or 9th round, more than 6. But when we have been asked 6th round, then answer will be 1 only. Now why answer will be 1 after 6th round? Because Shefu will always play optimally, and he wants to maximize his number. He knows that after 6th round game will finish. So after 5th round, instead of choosing odd even number, he will select odd number. That is 8 plus 5 is equal to 13. And now he is again at the open counter, because he knows that after 6 there is no operation to perform. So at 6 the candy that is present at 6 will also go to his slot only. So Shefu will get 14, and at 6 chef will remain 1. So this is the edge case that we have to see in this question. So this was the explanation when one was at beginning, when was at end, when one was at between and end. The only thing which we have to observe in this case is the index, the place of one only, and like this we have to solve this question. Now I will also show you the implementation, but before showing you implementation, I want you to implement this on your own, to just go and try this approach that when one is at beginning, just try and to see this video once more from when I have started explaining that what will be the case when one is at end, what will be the case when one is between beginning and end, then one is at beginning, then handle these cases, especially this case that at 6 is equal to when number of round required is only 6. Then we have to ask the query that after 6 then the chef answer will be 1 only, and in this case when there more than 6 is asked, then at 6 he will store 2 because Shefu will play optimally. Okay, so now when we will solve these thing, then the challenge comes to us that we have to solve this question in O of Q time complexity. That is in because R is going till R can be 10 power 12. So now how can we get this thing? How can we, R can be less than or equal to 10 power 12? So we cannot in 1 second, we cannot perform this thing. We cannot do O of Q into R. O of Q into R cannot be performed in 1 second. This cannot happen. We have to only perform in O of Q. So how we will do? That thing I am going to explain to you. In that thing we will pre-calculate. Now what we will pre-calculate? We will take an array, or suppose array name is ans, okay, and it is also of size n, okay, and we will after each round the maximum that chef can store after 1 round, we will store. Maximum chef can store after 2 round, we will store. Maximum chef can store after 3 round, we will store. Like this till n we can save. Because after n, you are seeing that after n, the same thing is repeating only. So we will use this thing and we will calculate the total sum that we are getting after n round. We can calculate the total sum after n round and use that And if suppose we can use that we can do that d, and d in d we will store r minus 1 divided by n. You can say that suppose if r is equal to the query that is asked is 6 and n is equal to 5, 6 is query is asked, then 6 minus 1 is equal to 5, 5 divided by n, that is 5 divided by 5 is equal to 1. So we have to add this sum one time, okay, and we will add ans of this r minus 1 mod n, you can say plus 1. If you are taking one base index, that after this one first round, what will be the answer? This I will also show you in the implementation. When I will show you the implementation, then you will understand it better. So this was the optimal approach that we can use to solve this question. And using brute force, you can solve the first subtask. But for passing the both subtasks, you need to pre-calculate till n. And after n, the value will be repeating. And we will simply divide it with the number of round that we are getting. That how many times we have to calculate the sum. We will multiply it with d and we will get the total sum. Okay. So this was all about the approach of this question. Now let's see the implementation. Okay, now let's see the implementation of this magical candy store question. Here I have taken the test cases input, that I have taken input in n, then array input is being taken in a, then number of query input is being taken in q, and the is used to because the answer can be very large, so I'm using m, that is taking 10 power 7. Ans array will store the updated max value, that is your best max with the best value of maximum candies that chef can get at ith index, that will be stored by ans. If I is equal, the first element is 1, then simply ans of 1 is equal to 1. I have told you in this array this explanation time. Okay, now if last element is 1, then what we will do, if index is odd we will add it. If index is odd, we will make it even. The value at index is odd, we will make it even. Otherwise, we will make it or we will simply add it. And at the same time, I am also storing the best value in my ans array. Okay. At last, only one is being added. So that's why its ans of n is equal to sum. Okay. The value is getting updated. Now, when one is in between, then if a of I is equal to 1, and if a of I minus 1 is your even, then I am subtracting it and making it odd. Okay, else I will just make it add 1 to sum and simply check for that. If it is even, then I will simply add it. If it is odd, I will simply subtract it. Now, why I am adding here at when the odd is coming? Okay, this is because to avoid the which we lose one at this place when the so because we are following this procedure that whenever we are getting odd, we are making it even. And we will similarly do for that position also, that is before 1, to get that 1 back, we are adding this thing. Okay, now again this answer 5 will be updated. Now if last element is odd, then we will simply add it, because at last element the round will be changed and the current shop at which chef is present, that shop will be closed, and he to change his position, now he will select at last element odd number only. For that he is selecting, if it is even he will make it odd, otherwise we will just simply add it, and at the same time we are putting the best value in the ans array. Okay, now here we are just calculating for each query. The thing I have told you that in D we will store the number of round that previously we have been played, and D2 with the index that which is being asked by the query, that at this round what was the value, we can get the best value which we have stored at that index by ans array. Here the brute force approach I have written, which I have commented out, that we will check for each from 1 to D2, we will check it, but this is not needed here in optimal approach. If it is a of 1 is equal to 1, simply sum of 2. In sum 2 I am storing the updated value of the sum. And if d2 is greater than 1, then simply answer of d2 minus 1 will be added. Okay, and a of d2 will be added. Now, why answer of d2? Because the previous best at the maximum candy present at the previous best, but it is but the last element, the rth element, will be always stored itself. That I used to tell, that rth element will be that that the round element, that if it is r is equal to 6, then sixth element, the element present at the sixth element will be always stored. That's why I have used a of d2. Okay, now it is the same thing. If r is greater than n, then we will simply do this sum of 2 is equal to n sum into d. That previous sum that we have calculated will be multiplied d times. That d is being calculated here. And if n is equal to 1 and a of 1 is equal to 1, then simply sum of 2 is equal to r. This is one of the edge case, that when n is equal to 1 and the value present at 1 is also 1. Okay, then after 2, what will be the value? It will be 2. After 3, it will be 3. After 4, it will be 4. So that case is being handled here. Okay, if n is equal to 1 and a of 1 is equal to 1, sum 2 is equal to r. At last, we are just appending our answer modulo m in the string, and you can see that this is passing the both the subtasks. Okay, so this was the implementation of Magical Candy Store. Hope you would have been able to understand.